Hey guys, Led here. I'm in Eastern Ohio at the original Bob Evans Farm slash restaurant. We're gonna go have breakfast and then walk around the place and try to make a video out of this. We'll keep you posted. All right, my belly's full. Now we're heading over to the museum. And we're gonna check out and see what they have inside there. Looks like Bob's old house, the homestead. Homestead was built in 1820. That's an old house. All right guys, we're walking into Bob's house. Ooh, bless you. Here we are in Bob's first restaurant. There's Bob. Cooking this fella some eggs and biscuits and gravy and sausage. And there's just a ton of reading to do in here. For those that didn't know, Bob served in World War II. Here's a bell that Bob used to have maybe at the fair or something, at his tent where he sold his food. He'd ring that bell. Sandwiches were 25 cents. Here's some of the hogs that since then they have won some ribbons with. There's Bob's hat. And some of his string ties. That hat, by the way, is a Stetson. There he is wearing it. Here's a TV commercial. It looks like they were shooting back in the day. Bob and his wife having some, looks like sausage sandwiches from Bob Evans Farm Sausage. That there, folks, is a Bob Evans biscuit cutter. Make your dough and roll around on top of it. It's pretty cool. It's a cool barn. Purple camouflage. We'll get down beside it and get a better picture of that side there. Check this out. Our farm salutes all those who serve. Here's something you probably didn't know. Bob Evans goes purple. When you mix all the colors together from our military, it turns to purple. That's pretty cool. This barn is a salute to all the military. I do appreciate that. Check this side out. This is your view from the road when you're driving by the farm. Here's another one of the barns on Bob Evans Farm. Out. Old schoolhouse. All right, we're going in the schoolhouse. Thank you. There's the desks. Up there's the chalkboard. There's the old stove. The stove's cool. Are you teaching, Leah? And it has an upstairs. Check this out. 8th grade final exam from 1895. Here's the questions. But it's pretty cool. I'm gonna go up these steps if they hold me. Oh, check out that bicycle. I'll get you. Go to that here in a second. So they got a gate up here that we can't go in any further than this, but at least we're allowed to come in here. It's pretty cool. This must be where the teacher stayed. Check that out. Got her bed, her table, little small potbelly stove right there where she can do a little cooking maybe. Very neat. Let's go look at that bicycle. Check out that old bicycle. One room schoolhouse. Were commonplace throughout rural America until 1920. There's a teacher's contract. Apparently teachers were not allowed to be married until their contract was up. There's the old teacher. And then right here, got the history of Gallia County. A bunch of kids that went there. Freedom Seekers, Ohio, and the Underground Railroad. Here's a small cabin that 9 girls lived in. And I don't know where they slept. I see one bed, which 2 or 3 small girls could have slept in. But 9 girls, this thing's about probably 15 by 15. They were crammed in here. There was 9 of them. There's the fireplace. That's the cabin that the 9 girls lived in. And that's the schoolhouse. Let's keep moving. I'm gonna try to block the sun a little bit with my hand. And here's the other side. All right, we're going in this cabin now. The craft cabin. There's a Bob Evans quilt, small one. It's pretty cool. All kinds of old stuff in here. Check out this sewing machine. Wheeler and Wilson Treadle sewing machine. Now that's old. You gotta pedal it. Pretty cool. Let's go to the next building. Walking into the Pioneer home. Alright, we're going into the Pioneer's home. And we'll just go upstairs. Here's his bed. Him and his Pioneer woman slept in. That's where their Pioneer baby slept, right there. I'm sure. toys that the kid used. Oops, sorry about that. Keep bumping the camera. There's a strap right there for sharpening his razor. Got two fireplaces. Looks like one for maybe heating water up, one for cooking. There's his musket. There's an old ironing board. Well, those windows right in the way though. Very cool. We got one more building to go through. Well, here's the thing. Pioneer living. When pioneers arrived in the area, there were many important jobs to be accomplished in the order to establish a new home. There's some of their chores. Inside chores, outside chores, chores in general. Let's keep moving. That's the pioneer's house from the outside. The next one over here is the mercantile. This must be the grocery store. So let's go see what the grocery store has to offer. Adamsville Mercantile. Sometimes between 1800 and 1830, the Stormont family built this cabin near Johns Creek, about 14 miles from the farm. So if you need a wagon wheel, you come to the mercantile store and you get a wagon wheel. If you need a corn or hay cutter, a scythe, a log hewer, any gardening tools, big crosscut saw up there over the fireplace with some antlers. You got a yoke right there for an ox. All kinds of stuff in here you can buy. There's a bee smoker with bellows from Root Quality Bee Surplus. Just all kinds of junk in this here surplus store. And there's the cash register. I guess it fell used. There's some candy back there. There's an old washing machine. Look at that. It's pretty cool. Alright, we're going to keep on moving. One thing they did is the doors were very low. I got to duck my head to go into this thing. Alright guys, that does it for Bob Evans and his farm. On the way out of here, I'm going to do a drive-by so you can see the entire farm. They got some horses and barns and other things. Any comments or questions about this video, please put down beneath and subscribe if you could. Let out.